Thank you for Patreon now for donating to the Patreon. Hey guys, it's Van Diezel, back again with another Shadowverse Champions Battle videos. Because you're into tight, come subscribe, and also subscribe. So what happened in the last one is we started playing this amazing game, Shadowverse, with our new character, Ezel, who I forgot his real name, but he does actually appear in the anime of Shadowverse Flame. But anyways, we battled and we learned how to play Shadowverse very horribly. But we did end up meeting Hiro and my favorite character, also Memori, my other favorite character, and then Kazuki, a nice character that I like. Really enough, I used to like Kazuki more than I like either of them two, then after playing this game, I liked Kazuki a little less compared to them. But anyways, yeah, so after running into Kagura, the very scary, word for word from our character, class Prez, word for word from Hiro's character, we end up running away, finding our phone, coming back, and we started playing Shadowverse. And I don't know how to get to the courtyard, apparently. I'm actually lost. Wait, oh my god, I'm an idiot. It's literally right here. I forgot that there's directions on the things. But yeah, so this time, Hero's gonna delve more into Shadowverse since we only got the bare minimum last time. And like I said before, you really only get to play with the... You don't get to play with the actual normal defense of a Shadowverse game, which is 20, until you reach a very specific point in the game. So we're basically going to be stuck on baby mode for a while, and that's not something I can change, or at least not to my knowledge. If there's something I can do to change about it, I would say comment it down below, but I don't know if I'm going to read those before this actually goes up.
Let's get this ball rolling.
Okay.
Shadowverse 101, Lesson 1, How to Build a Deck.
I know how to build a deck,
here,
Hero.
Take this.
Oh, thank you. Didn't mean to cut you off there. Beginner Dragoncraft deck.
That's called a deck code. You can use it to create a deck in the blink of an eye.
I hate using those.
Let's try making your first deck. Go ahead and take out your phone.
I hate using deck codes because it's like, I hate building anyone else's deck that isn't my own.
The deck code menu.
It doesn't feel like it belongs to me, and I hate that.
Now choose the deck code I just gave you.
So obviously you can pick from other classes. I literally tried to leave and it said no. But there's Forest class, Swordcraft, I believe that's Runecraft, Dragoncraft, my main, Shadowcraft, Bloodcraft, and Havencraft. We will get onto those later. But for now, I will build the... What's the difference between the two decks?
Now choose the deck.
Let me view the deck, dammit! Hiro, you are a bitch!
Now use the deck code I just gave you.
This is the deck code you just gave me. Anyways, Fafnir is actually my ace. I said before that I had an ace in Dragoncraft. This is Fafnir. This is my ace card, legitimately.
Now choose the deck code I just gave you.
I'm literally hitting the deck code you just gave me, goddammit.
Now choose the deck code I just gave
you. I don't know what it wants from me. I'm actually trying. I'm an idiot.
Oh, wait a sec. Looks like you're missing some cards.
I'm a fucking idiot. I was clicking on the other deck.
We'll get you all sorted out. For now, go ahead and close the menu.
Okay.
If you're short some cards, you can always track a deck code. Tracking a deck code makes it easier to hunt for the cards you're missing. Try tracking a deck code now.
Can I not? Is that an option?
Almost
I don't care.
There. Try tracking. Yeah, just like that. All right, time to move on. Go ahead and put your phone away.
New decks are always exciting. Collect decks. I hate, like I said, deck codes, but they give you one after every fight, so.
Here comes your next lesson. Shadowverse 101. Lesson 2. Collecting cards. There are three ways you can get cards. Buying them individually, buying card packs, or winning Shadowverse matches.
Right.
You'll find cards and packs on sale at shadow vendors like this one.
They're almost everywhere.
As for matches, there are tons of players out there to face off against, but you can start with me.
Oh, 100%.
So basically, you've got two assignments. Buy cards and packs from the Shadow Vendor, and challenge me to a match. Think you're up to it?
As long as I get to build my own deck, hell yeah. Because, again, I love... Okay, maybe it's because of my first experience with Fafnir, but, when you walk up to an NPC that you can fight, you can actually see the deck that they use and their class, which makes it easier if you want to, like, battle against certain people. But anyways, I love...
Okay, it's shopping time.
Oh, we're gonna want that. Oh, I never noticed that. What's the penny?
Ooh, check it out. There's a Sky Dragon Ethica for sale. That's one of the cards you were missing, right? First one's free. Might as well snag it.
That's cool. Yeah, So that sometimes they have deals like that where you can get cards for free.
You got yourself a great new card. Looks like there was only one in stock though, so we can't buy any more. Okay, let's try buying a card pack next.
I think that's how it always is, where there's only
one
in stock.
Scroll through the menu and buy a card pack.
Man, I really want that Ivory Dragon too. I love that card.
Your
they also have sleeves sometimes.
Free, so why not, right? Try buying a card pack.
Okay, what am I gonna pull? Is it always guaranteed to pull whatever? Or like...
Appreciate ya.
I don't know. Anyways, let's see. I know I've become a better Shadowverse player since I first, you know, played this game, so I'm curious to see how I've grown. Okay. Hi. Shapeshifting Mage. Interesting. We got a good card. And another Fire Lizard, which is something we apparently needed for that deck.
Oh, sweet! You got the Fire Lizard you were missing! The more cards and packs you buy, the more decks you'll be able to build.
Can I build my deck
new
now?
Packs go on sale all the time, so don't forget to come back and check every now and then.
Okay.
You'll need rupees to buy cards and packs from here on out, so start saving up.
Right. Pack contains 8 cards. Newly acquired cards you've already possessed, 3 of will automatically be exchanged, because you at most can only run 3 copies of the same
now
card in your deck.
I'll show you how to win cards from playing matches. Go ahead and challenge me.
Can I build a deck first? Is that an option? Damn it! Fine, be that way, hero.
Can we talk?
Oh, I realize it's the Y button.
Ready for our one-on-one?
I hate how it's always how you're trained to do the A button for everything else, but whatever. Oh, my basic Dragoncraft deck, the deck I like to play. I get to use that one. And obviously, victory rewards, you see, you can get these cards. I think you can always get whatever's listed
awesome.
On that, guaranteed.
Then let's do this!
So, we get to play hero.
The more cards, the more you play, while getting better at the game at the same time. So what do you say? Let's get better together! Shadowverse Showdown!
Again, we're not going to be able to play with the normal 20 defense for a while, which is something I do hate about this game. But, like, it's nice it's nice to baby someone into it, but they take way too long to, you know, make it not 20 to- I think, like, the time they do it at, they could do it a little bit early, but at least the match that they actually make it 20 defense at, it's at least a good idea. Or what was that? 20 defense for your opponent. You get to play at 20 defense for some reason. Anyways, this class specializes in getting empty play points or to activate overflow. Overflow activates. Overflow effects can be utilized when you have 7 or more play points. That little counter we saw before, it will go up every time we get play points and, or go down every time we get play points because that's how many turns before. I actually like this hand, so I'll keep it. But yeah, so we want to get to 7 play points as soon as possible, so this counter goes to 0.
This
so,
is what Shadowverse is all about.
That's the first time we get to hear our character's voice. You can use L to- I never knew that. You can get hints. Really? Oh my god, how long has that button been there? There was one specific match that I had hell with. Anyways, this is what's called Ramp Dragoncraft, where, you know, you just gain a bunch of resources. So, by gaining extra play point, I play Dragon Oracle! One of my favorite spells! So, as you saw, it had an overflow effect, and pretty much, if you're in overflow, you get to draw a card. But, a lot of cards have different overflow effects. Like, I think Dragon Rider right here, right? Yeah, if you're in overflow, you have this effect act for you, and like it says, you get 7 or more play points. And obviously you want to increase your stats as fast as possible. I will hit this thing with a Serpent's Wrath arbitrarily because I can and I will. Because I don't like to spend unnecessary creatures. But also, since we went second, we got more draws than Hero did, and we have more Evo points, which is very useful for late game moves. So draw. Okay, Death Dragon. Because we have play points to use them. Let's go Fighter.
I live by the sword!
And let's go, because you're not a fanfare effect, you're just continuous. Let's go Dragon Rider.
And I are one.
And let's evolve our fighter. I should have played that a little bit smarter. I should have played the Firstborn Dragon to save on play points for later turns, but whatever. It is what it is. But yeah. So, and now we can see what the AI can do when it draws. Also, I really love Hero's reaction when he hits overflow. I really want this game to last until he hits overflow, because I want to see it again. Because I haven't seen it in fucking forever, and I love it. Anyway, Strike, that's another thing, and actually because we both have a Disaster Dragon, let's go over what Strike does. Strike is an effect that found on followers. Strike activates when the follower attacks an opponent's follower or leader. Strike does not activate when it's receiving the attack. It has to be the attacker. But There are some cards that say follower strike or leader strike, meaning those strikes only proc up when they attack a specific kind of target. So if it says follower strike, it only can work on followers. If it says leader strike, it only works when it attacks the leader. And this is why I should have played a little bit smarter for play points, but you know what? It's fine, because we'll call upon my own Disaster Dragon. Sadly, this only does 2 damage, but... Yeah, there's not a real way I want to do this. Shinkara. Again, I hate the fact how we get to sit at a freebie 20 and heroes at a constant 10, and that's pretty much how it will be for the longest time, which again is annoying, but you can't really fix that. If he had ward active, and he's dead. And now we're in overflow. I kind of want to let hero live just so I can hear him scream overflow. But I'm not going to, so... Hero, I really am sorry about this, mate. That's game.
This should finish it. You are unstoppable!
Why did we have to win before he could say overflow? I really want to hear him say it. When we get to that match later where he goes full tryhard, it will be worth it. Anyways, these are the cards we got from it. We got Twin-Headed Dragon. I'm not going to look at every card that we get. I'm just doing this for the sake of example. Gain Storm if you're in overflow. Like I said with Storm, I'm an idiot. That's not what that card says at all. It can attack if you're in overflow. Oh, Conflagration. My best counter spell. It deals 4 damage to all followers. That is the perfect nuke card against anything. And I love it. And I love the fact that we got card sleeves for it as well. We got 100 rupees. Now we can buy more packs. Freebie jump. Anyways, yeah, I love Dragoncraft. We can ramp up cost. And if we saw Fafnir that game, you would understand why.
Natural. When you play a match, you'll earn experience points for the class you used. You can even get cards when your class level goes up.
Like that conflagration we got.
That conflagration you just got is one of the cards you needed for your deck. Lucky you.
It's actually one of the most important cards I've ever had in my entire life.
Cards every time you win. So get out there and kick some Shadowverse butt.
I think it's only 3 times the first time you win against that opponent.
Looks like you found all the cards you were missing. Let's try making that deck again.
Can I not make your deck, please? Because it is great, but it doesn't have Fafnir in it. And Fafnir is...
Okay.
I'm not joking.
In the deck code menu.
I'm being legit serious. Fafnir is actually my ace. I'm being, like, dead serious on that. And I feel that way forever.
Nice.
But...
looks like we can make that deck now. Okay. Try creating a deck.
I wish I could build my own, but I guess I'll just build it off of heroes.
Now you need to save your deck.
Can I not, though?
Not quite.
I hate-
save your deck.
Damn it, Hero!
Congrats! You made your first deck! Way to go! Once you've made a new deck you want to use, it's time to set it as your active deck.
I don't want to set this as my active deck.
And that's how it's done.
I did not click any
of
that.
You need decks to play Shadowverse. And to make decks, you'll need cards.
Right.
And to get cards, you can stop by the Shadow Vendors. Oh! Don't forget to play against people to win even more cards.
Right.
Sometimes you'll even get a deck code. Whoa! Create
right.
decks, play matches, collect cards, create more decks.
Right.
No two matches are ever the same. The thrill never gets old. That's what Shadowverse is all about.
Half argue that, half don't. Cards separate into 8 different classes. Most cards can only be used in their respective classes. The last class that is not on here technically isn't in the game, and that's Portalcraft. But there's the actual neutral class, which can be used in every deck. Yeah, neutral cards, however, that's the last class. You can unlock an opponent's class by defeating them in a match. There are 8 classes in total, with the neutral class and dragon class being available at the start. Craft, and play lots of cards, games to unlock cards.
I think you're all set.
Okay.
Hey guys, how goes the war?
I beat Hero, kind of.
We just wrapped up going over the basics.
Sweet. Guess that means we're good to go.
Now the only thing left to do is...
look for the Shadowverse Club.
Yeah. Do you really think we'll find it, though?
Don't worry. We've got an extra pair of eyes now. So that club's as good as found.
You know, I actually believe you this time.
Me too.
Oh, it's because I'm here.
All right. The hunt for the Shadowverse Club is back on.
Yeah, baby. Like how we're already energizing to it.
Okay, so how do you guys want to do this? Another lap around the school?
Well, we've already checked everywhere we could think of. Maybe we should try asking around again.
That didn't work out too great for us before. It might be time to switch things up, you know?
Yeah, think we could ask something different this time?
Let's ask about the advisor, actually, because if it's a club, you know, there might be people.
Oh, that's right! You can't have a club without an advisor.
Why didn't we think of that? I bet if we figure out who it is, they'll lead us right to the club.
Okay, then let's ask about the club advisor. Any more ideas?
Might as well, because you're probing. Let's ask about the club room.
Yeah, that'd probably be the fastest way, you know?
They must be using an empty classroom somewhere.
Wow, such a... I don't want to insult me more, never mind.
Let's ask about the club room. Any more ideas? Actually, guess that about does it. We've got our game plan.
Right.
Yeah, we'll track down the club advisor and figure out where the club room is.
Yes.
If we're looking for people to ask, classrooms might be a good place to start.
My one thing with this game, dialogue.
Roger that. Let the hunt for the Shadowverse Club begin!
Okay, I will say this though. This is the one game I actively lost track of time with. Like, have you ever heard that saying, you know, that, okay, I don't care about online. My thing never works when we play online anyways. Okay, anyways, as I try to... Oh! Huh. So, for the record, the mythical cards are stuff the characters use in the anime. They are very good. Okay. Anyways, so we're gonna have a fight before we actually do story. I'm gonna do this because I hate having extra decks if I don't need them. How do I delete this? No, I want to delete this deck. Active. Wait, what did I do? I'm actually confused on what I did. ZR, so does active deck. Can I, delete this? I can't. Okay, well, we're gonna build my real deck this time. Anyways, how Dragoncraft is supposed to be played, you want to get some play orbs up, and that's what I like to do. I like to ramp up my play orbs as fast as possible and play super aggressive cards very early on that are high cost, such as my ace over here, if I can get to him. Please, that be at 3 copies. I only have one of them. Really? I only have one copy of Fafnir, which means all those games I had Fafnir in them. I legitimately either top decked or I got really lucky. Anyways, you know, having abilities to get extra play orbs, that's what we want to go for. Any effects that activate during overflow. I like getting rid of all my neutral cards right out the gate just because I don't like playing the neutral class. It feels like they're handy, like handouts. I don't think they're bad cards. I just, you know, think that they're handouts and I don't like them. So we're going to do that. This deck is going to be very high cost because I'm getting rid of literally every single neutral card right out the gate. So... we're definitely gonna run into a cost problem at some point. I wouldn't be surprised. Actually, wait, no, fuck that card. And we'll up that by one. And is there any other Dragon Class cards I see? I don't see any. So for now, that's where this deck will stop. We're going to save this deck. Save changes. And now I have to remember how to change the name of it. I did not mean to do that. Deck menu. There we go. Oh, there we go. That's how we delete deck. Okay, deck menu. Go away. No, we're not copying this deck. Delete it. Okay, now we'll... I gotta stop remembering to do that. Okay, why? We will change sleeve because I think we have other sleeves. Yeah. So, we'll make a conflagration just because I like this. Our character... oh, we can use different characters when we... oh, wait, no, those are just the different sleeve archetypes. Okay, never mind. Finally, we're gonna rename it to... Fafnir Flames, just cut. We're going to rename it to Fafnir Flames, and now we'll actually start playing the game. But yeah, so again, we're not going to be able to play so many real matches for a while, but I love Fafnir. He's like my ace just because I remember the first game, I used to actually not like him at all. This game made me like everything that I hated about Shadowverse. Like, but I used to not like Fafnir at all. And then, how do I accept this deck? Oh, yeah, plus. It's, I didn't mean to do that. Plus. Fafnir Flames. Fafnir Flames is right. Okay, anyways, I used to hate Fafnir just because it was high cost and he only did 2 damage to all other followers, including your own. However, Fafnir became really useful. Oh, yeah, this data box. So these are how you, yeah, they're just various items. Sometimes they're packs, sometimes they're rupees, sometimes they're cards. I'll play against you just because you're a Bloodcraft player. Bloodcraft is very simple to fight against. I always forgot that it was the A button. But anyways, there was a game where I don't remember exactly, but I needed specifically a board nuke, and I was all out of conflagrations, and I top decked Fafnir in the last moment that I could have needed him. And I was like, oh my god, wait. So I played Fafnir, and I won. And as we hear the music, like I said, every single class has a unique track. We didn't get to hear Heroes or the Dragoncraft one because, you know, it was tutorial music, but I promise you, it is epic, especially that match that we will have with Hero very later on into the story. It'll be worth it to wait that long. I should have mulliganed for play or boosters. That's why when we get the chance, we're gonna try to find as many play or boosters as possible, because we want to like jumpstart our ramp as early as the game can. This is an important card, Drain. So how Drain works is when a follower attacks, not when it deals damage in general, but when it attacks and does damage, whether it's to leader or the enemy, equal to the damage you dealt, whether all of it was dealt or not, you gain life equal to the damage that attacked. So basically, like, say for example, this attacked this and destroyed it, even if it had like, somehow it evolved and it had 3 attack, and just died even though it only took 2 damage, you would still recover 3 life. Anyways, I could get rid of that now, but instead, oh, her max defense is 15. Okay, never mind then. So we can at least play on not where they're at half. We at least can play with them being at close to ours, which is good. I did let the Drain stuff live for a reason. Don't worry, it's fine. Because I also have a board nuke in hand, so I'm not worried entirely. But what we will do is we'll play Blazing Breath. We'll get rid of that one. We will try a dragon that one. And now we will see, because Drain didn't trigger, we'll now cut down their life a little bit more. And that right there, you see how ours is for overflow and it will drop to 0 in 2 turns. Theirs is Vengeance. And I will, thankfully they played that card, so I will now get to show you what Vengeance actually does. Vengeance, I don't know why the AI doesn't evolve actually, it should have evolved and killed my board. But Vengeance is active at any point once your leader's defense hits 10 or less. So once their leader takes 3 more damage, they will forever be in Vengeance until they gain more defense. And that ability is a pain in the ass to deal with sometimes. Not every time, but a lot of times it's a pain in the ass. So what we're gonna do is bombard, because fuck keeping them out of Vengeance. Sometimes, you know, to quote a character from the anime, when dealing with Vengeance, you have to know the timing. If you know that they're gonna be dangerous if you put them into Vengeance, don't put them into Vengeance. But A, the AI is stupid, and B, there's Fafnir. I also used to think this was his head, so I thought he was like a legit serpent with giant wings. Apparently this is his head, which makes me hate him a little bit, but I mean, it's fine. We'll call, I think I have to evolve for game. I think. I don't think this is game. This might not be game. I might be like one off. I am one off. I'm legitimately. Oh, never mind. I thought Dragon Rider had one attack for a second. Most Shadowverse games take 5 minutes. Legitimately, like, I've timed myself playing Shadowverse against other people and against AIs, whether it's in this game or whether it's in, those are really good cards. We'll go over them later when we're building our other decks. Oh, that's a good one, against Storm when we're in Overflow. But anyways, we'll edit our deck later with more stuff, but for now, that's pretty much it for the fighting. We can now create, oh, we have to fight all those people? To get the class? So we can't just build our own Bloodcraft deck without... Okay, well, new mission. Fuck the story. We're gonna do this first. Because I want to be able to build all the decks, so we're gonna fight against... We're just gonna abuse the ever-living hell out of Dragoncraft, pretty much. We're gonna see exactly how Dragoncraft plays. But that means I get to talk more, and I will play against a random Dragoncraft player just to show it off. But, okay, that's all one in the courtyard. But, anyways... I also love this because Forestcraft is one of my other favorite classes because it's a combo deck. I like every deck for its own respective reasons. Havencraft is the one I like the least just by default, but I love Forestcraft. It actually has my main... I do main Dragoncraft, but there is one specific deck in Forestcraft that I will say I main over everything else, and that is Cosmos Fang. Sadly, she is not in the game, but I love her. That's all I'm gonna say. But draw... I'm hitting this with a Blazing Breath so we don't have to deal with this later. Because I like keeping my defense up. That's kind of the thing. But yeah, we need to start ramping more. And like I was trying to say earlier, but I kind of got sidetracked. The thing I love about this game is this is the first game I have played in a while that I legitimately lost track of time playing. Like, straight up, when I was playing, every time I would play this, before I even thought about recording it, I would start it and I would literally realize the time was 2 hours later when I finally looked up the time again without realizing that 2 hours had legitimately passed. Like, it is the only thing that kept me completely focused on the game without me moving away from it. I don't want to waste an evolution point here. Maybe that was stupid, but I don't want to waste evolution points unless I have to. And I'm kind of saving my play points for something. So we'll take that. We'll draw. Okay. Disaster Dragon. Next turn we play both Twin-Headed and Depth Dragon when we're in Overflow. Disaster Dragon evolves. If for some reason she doesn't kill this, that's the other both good and annoying thing about this game, is everything has a voice line, like I said, including the cards, but when you're trying to talk over it, it's kind of annoying, but you know, it is what it is. Forest Crab, as you can see, focuses on just spamming fairies left, right, and center, and this. They like their combo count to be really high. Oh! So that's what they mean by, updates were involved. I don't remember that card being in the game before! Anyways, here's our boy who gains 3 in Overflow. Wait, does that mean I have access to more powerful cards? Oh, this is gonna be such an amazing Let's Play. Oh, this Let's Play is gonna be so fun. Because that means I have access to so many more cards. But that means I also gotta play a lot smarter. Oh god, I'm now worried about Lucia. Oh, I'm so worried. I'll explain what Lucia is later, but,
you won't escape.
Okay, sure. As she continues to play aggressively, I wish we do have a little bit more ramp cards. In the last few days, because I have played Shadowverse on my phone a little bit, I've had really bad luck with ramp cards. For some reason, I'm just not drawing them. I don't know why the AI is not evolving. The AI just does AI things sometimes. Play. Firstborn gains ward when you're in Overflow. So there he goes. You have 5 attack, I believe, when you enter. When you evolve, I hope you have 5 attack. Okay, well. I'm not letting my thing die just for that. I'm gonna deal with that because, Fafnir is a thing! Fafnir, when summoned, does 2 damage to everything else on the board. I love that effect because it's, like, what I still remember that first game. Like I said, I don't remember all of it detail for detail. All I remember is I was being board rushed and everything had low defense. I needed Fafnir to clear the board, and just so I can show this off, for no other reason. Actually, if I didn't do that, I had game. But, you know what? Fuck it. Fafnir. I now realize I can't evolve, but you know what? It's fine. I win. It doesn't matter. She can't clear my board no matter what she does. Fafnir is physically unstoppable at this point. And she, for some reason, kills Okani.
Hey, let's play!
And this is game. Fafnir, finish it.
This should finish it.
Wow, you're good.
So that's pretty much what this episode is gonna be, me fighting all the classes. I don't really know if I wanna keep all these in. Like,
good game.
Oh yeah. I don't think Rhinosaurus was in the original. I don't think Rhinosaurus I played against in the original game, which means Rhinosaurus was added, which means the more sets are in here, which means I can buy more unique cards and play more unique decks. I really can't wait to find out if that's true or not, because we know the mythic cards are in here, and I know they weren't in the game the last time I played, or at least according to the game it wasn't. So, yeah. I think what we're going to do is, how many rubies do we have? We have 440. I like buying packs at 10 at a time. So what I think we're going to do is we're going to quickly add the new cards we just got so the deck becomes a little bit less high cost. Edit deck. We will, you know, create more decks next episode, and I'm pretty much going to end this one here, but in the next time, we won't continue the story, we'll just continue playing, because I don't want to skip at least any of these first matches with all the decks, because I do want to show off them a little bit more, or show them off a little bit more. So, you know, the next episode is pretty much going to be a little lackluster. What's your stats? Are you just, yeah, you're kind of just a iffy card. I'd rather just have Fafnir, so we'll drop the cost for one. This card is actually really useful. She helped me out so much in, and very certain plays, and she was actually a part of my win con at some point just because of a certain combo she would do with Fafnir. But without further ado, I'm gonna end this one here. I hope you guys enjoyed. In the next one, we will continue our battles, and then hopefully we'll also get a little bit of taste of the story. Oh, I see here over there. So, I'm on this one here. I hope you guys enjoyed. Do not forget to like, comment, subscribe, join us, follow Twitch, and don't forget, Shadowverse Showdown.